Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel and another video. In this video, I'm doing a kids furniture makeover on my kids chairs and table. These items are located in their playroom. We've had these items for 2 to 3 years and it's starting to show. The legs are falling apart. The fabric needs to be changed out. The table has writing on it due to the kids coloring with crayons, markers, pens, pencils, anything you can think of, it's on the table. Also, I brought an additional item for their playroom. I found this ottoman at my local thrift store and thought it would be a great seating item for them. If you like this type of content, make sure you hit that subscribe button and also click on that notification bell so you won't miss out on any content like this. Now that we have all that out the way, let's get to the video. The first step I did was detaching the legs from the chairs since I was going to paint all 8 legs. Once that was finally detached, I used these pliers to remove the fabric from the chairs. And you guys, I was struggling. The struggle was real. I could not for the life of me lift up any nails from this chair. I even tried using a pair of scissors and it wasn't budging. So after a while, I just started ripping the fabric from the chair. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Sherri. My content consists of DIYs, organization, and lifestyle. Make sure you click on that subscribe button and that notification bell so you won't miss out on any of my uploads. If you're an oldie, welcome back. Make sure you like this video and leave a comment down below. As you see here, the old staples are still in the chair, but you won't be able to see it when I use the new fabric. Now I had to prep the table for staining, and with prepping, I used this wood filler to fill in any cracks, along with this 80 grit sandpaper and a handheld sander to sand the wood filler. You want to make sure that before applying the filler, that the table is completely clean and dry. My kids had dried up glue on the table, but I didn't stress about it because I knew that the sander was going to remove all the debris off the table. But in general, you want to make sure that the table is completely clean before applying the wood filler. I did not sand the legs of the table or the chairs because the top of the table needed the sanding the most. Once I got done with the handheld sander, I used a cloth to wipe away the debris and applied a second layer of the wood filler and used this medium sanding sponge and only sand the areas where I put the filler in. Once that was completely dried, it was now time for the staining. I used the Minwax pre-stain wood condition and the gel stain. The pre-stain just protects the wood and helps prep the wood for the actual staining, which will be the gel stain. I applied the pre-staining to the top of the table along with the sides, also the legs of the chairs. And once that completely dried, I applied the gel stain. You can use any type of brush to apply gel stain, a paintbrush, a foam brush, even a rag. I decided to use this towel. I evenly distribute the staining onto the surface of the table, also the sides of the table. I let it sit for a few minutes and then wiped away the excess stain. The gel stain is black. That is the color theme in my kids' playroom, black and white. This is a neutral color. I have a boy and a girl, and their toys will actually bring different colors to the room. If you want your stain to appear darker, then it has to sit a little bit longer. I honestly didn't have to wipe the stain to begin with because I wanted the top of the table to be black, but I did. And when I did, I kind of freaked out a little bit because I wasn't used to wiping the stain that early, but I just wind up adding a second layer of that same gel stain. And the second time I used a brush because the white cloth was leaving a white fabric on the table. I also painted the legs of the table white with this chalk paint. I did the same process as far as the gel staining for the chair's legs as well. I applied two layers of the gel stain to the table and the chairs of the legs. You have to wait 12 hours between each layer, but once everything was completely dried, I used a fine grit and these protective coats to seal everything together. When those items were drying, I went on ahead and moved to adding the fabric to the chairs. I purchased my fabric from Hobby Lobby, and I just had to rip the fabric off the cushion because I could not lift up any nails. I used my staple gun to staple the fabric onto the seat cushions as well as the top of the chairs and the ottoman. Before adding the new fabric, of course I had to get rid of the old, so I used these pliers and ripped the old fabric from the ottoman. Since these items were going in my kids' playroom, I allowed them to pick which fabrics they wanted. They chose the musical and the plain black fabrics. That black fabric will be going on this ottoman. I added extra cushioning by adding batting to the sides. I used my adhesive spray and sprayed the foam before adding the batting. I used my hot glue gun for the folds on the sides of the ottoman, but followed up with my staple gun to make sure that those folds did not move. Once the legs were completely dried, I was able to add the fabric to the chairs. I had two pieces of fabrics to add to each chair. For the front, I just stapled the fabric to the back of the legs. And for the back fabrics, I folded the sides and the top and stapled those as well to the back of the legs. For the bottom portion of the fabric, I stapled that to the bottom parts of the chair. So the last and final step was adding the legs back to the chairs, and this is how everything turned out. Everything came together so perfectly, and I love the table. It is so gorgeous. But most importantly, the kids love their new furniture and their ottoman. I hope you guys like this kids' furniture makeover. If so, leave a comment down below and click on that like button. Make sure you are subscribed and that those notification bells are turned on. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye.